6 something, I threw on a sweater and a jacket, and I have my snow boots on, and then I get to Vegas, and it's hot and sunny, and no one's wearing snow boots. So I now have a bag filled with sweaters and jackets. Very prepared Canadian right here. I did bring my bathing suit, though, and an SPF, so I'm prepared. How's the day been going so far? Is it just kicking off? Or you guys been had a couple hours? Or what's up? Oh, Chad. Yeah, I saw Chad's Instagram last night on his ghost hunt, his Reeves impersonation. Did anyone else see that?
Yes. It was.
I don't know if you should be yelling there's a bomb and that we're all gonna die. I don't know if that's what the host of a night usually do, but Chad gets away with stuff like that.
It was amazing.
And if anyone had a bomb, I would follow Chad's lead. I think he'd know what to do. I don't know why. I just trust the guy. Even though he gave me, I was with him for one of the scariest experiences of my life. in London a year and a half ago, we went to this haunted room. You know how Chad is. And, you know, he searches this 400-year-old hotel to find the scariest room and then brings me along. And she starts talking to spirits and seeing these orbs in the room when he takes photos and stuff. And it was like, thanks, man. Not the introduction to the other world that I was hoping for. I also did what's that game that you're not supposed to play? Ouija. I did that about 2 months ago with my girlfriend and a couple of her friends, and it was so stupid. Because I don't know what you're expecting to get. Like, the first guy, his name was Ed, and he said he was from like an hour away, and the next thing he wrote was die. And didn't even correlate at all. And then I was out of that. That was the last time I participated, and the three girls kept playing, and the next spirit told them to go to hell or something like that. So it just doesn't seem like a lot of fun to me. So I'm not playing that game ever again. I remember my girlfriend too well, because she was in London England or wherever the hell we were, when Chad was doing his ghost adventures. And I remember we got back to our hotel room, and my girlfriend said, let's take some pictures in our room, see what kind of spirits we can see in our room. I was like, no. We're going to sleep. Unless Chad's having a sleepover, we are not doing that. And Chad wasn't into a sleepover, so. I didn't really ask. He might have been. You have a question, or are you just manning the mic? Or womaning the mic, sorry. It's 2017, people. What would I say though? Are you personing the mic? Are you holding the mic down? So I guess I'll just talk here for 40 minutes and that'll be that. Oh, we got one question. You coming up?
Hi. I was just wondering.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm like 5 foot, so.
I'm not much taller.
I was just wondering if you remember your reaction when they said, oh, you have to put on a hot dog costume.
I wasn't super stoked on it. I knew that I was going to be like a hot dog vendor, but I didn't realize how colorful the costume was going to be. And I've told this story a couple times before, but we were working like in Gascon in Vancouver, which is a cool area, and there were some people walking by, and it was a beautiful sunny day, and I went outside in my hot dog outfit, so I had the, you know, red pants and the striped shirt and the hat and the wiener on my chest and the wiener on my head. A couple cute girls walked by, and they smiled at me, so I smiled back, and they kept walking, and then I realized a few steps later that they were probably laughing at me and not like, you know, flirting, smiling with me. That was the moment I realized that this outfit was a winner. But it's cool, because it's kind of turned into, you know, into like this thing that's synonymous with Samantriel and my character, you know? I've seen fans cosplay it. I love seeing photos and videos of people replicating it, you know? And a couple girls do like a skirted version, so they make it, you know, nice and pretty. Where mine was not nice and pretty. I remember the pants were like this baggy, and the shirt was ill-fitting too. I guess that's what they were going for. So I wasn't happy to answer your question, but I'm happy about it now.
Thank you.
You're welcome, thanks for the question. I'm just gonna walk back and forth because I'm jacked off of caffeine right now.
Hi Tyler, thanks for being able to come to the convention so quickly.
Thanks for having me guys, I'm happy to be here.
So I've been watching the show for 12 years. So I remember seeing you in season one in the episode Bugs.
Yeah, fan favorite.
And I'm terrified of bugs, so I don't know how you got that.
I was too.
Okay. So what was it like getting a call back from Super Afterway? So we're gonna bring you back, but not as...
It was cool. Honestly, I didn't think I was gonna get it, because I had to go back and audition again. And I was like, they know that I was already in the show, right? it was cool. Like, I was happy to go back, and then it turned into like a multi-episode arc, which was something I didn't expect either. I remember I was on set for with Samantriel, and the wardrobe lady came up to me to take my measurements for pants because I had to get another set made. And I was like, well, this is my last day, you know? And she's like, well, maybe there's more in store for some Adrielle, you know? So it's nice when people outside of the creative world kind of give you hints as to what maybe is going on, because they're always the ones who read the scripts before anyone else. But I was happy to come back, and I had a blast. Like, that was my first episode, was very early in my acting career. I was 17 years old. It was like my second guest star role, so I'm on like this, you know, big show with these actors like Jensen and Jared that I recognize from other shows, and and now look at this experience here. You know, this experience wouldn't have happened for me if I didn't come back as some Montreal, likely, because I get tweets every now and then about how great the episode of the Bucks is. It's incredible how much, I don't want to say hate, because no one hates the episode. They just say it's their least favorite, or like, I can't believe they made that episode, or...
Well, Kirby has even said he hates that episode.
Eric Kirby, you said?
Yeah, he said that. He like dreads it, like every time it's brought up, it's one of those like,
Yeah. So I was in LA 4 or 5 years ago for a show called Revolution. Is that Kirby? And I had a callback, and I went, you know, I'm nervous because it's a callback for like a cool show. And I'm walking around the corner, and Jon Favreau's in it, as well as Aaron Kripke's in the audition. And I was feeling good. I went in. They're like, hey, Tyler, where are you from? I'm like, Vancouver. He goes, oh, we filmed Supernatural. I'm like, actually, I was on an episode. He's like, which one? I was like, Bugs, actually. He goes, oh, yeah. He's like, you know, the fandom considers that our worst episode. And I'm like, oh yeah, so I'm just sitting here with my sides, you know, about to audition for these people, and he's telling me that I'm a part of the worst episode of the series that he's filming. So my confidence skyrockets. And he goes, no, it had nothing to do with you, you know, it had to do with the CGI, and we were overambitious, and we tried to fill, you know, the room with these bees, but it just looked like little computer blips, and he was talking for honestly 5 minutes, and I'm sitting here listening to him talk about this episode of television I did that was the worst in his TV series, and I'm nervous, and I'm, you know, sweating, and like all those things that come with nerves, and eventually Jon Favreau was just like, hey, let's let the kid read, you know? He's like, let's give the kid a break. He's clearly sweating out up there. And he wasn't being mean. He was just, you know, talkative. And you know, I think he was trying to make me feel comfortable, but that wasn't the result.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
We don't think Bugs is the worst anymore. There
have been worse. Yeah! Am I still in like a top, not me, but is the episode still like top 10 at the bottom?
Yeah.
That's
still
a quick yes.
There's like two.
It's not too far removed.
There's two that are definitely worse.
And it's like, it has like a vintage classic thing now, right? Season one, they're like finding their legs, right?
It's gonna be troublesome for me.
But for you, I watched the Roman Cat Christmas.
Very distracting.
That was a blast.
It was really actually.
I can try to hold it
there
like that.
There were many stories from working with such a famous actor as the Roman Cat.
As the cat. The cat had the biggest trailer on set. I'm not even kidding. It had an Xbox, a flat screen TV, bunch of beds. It's ridiculous. And I'm sitting in like a trailer as big as this cubicle. Waiting to go to set. No, I'm sitting on this bench that doubles as a toilet. I've made it. Yeah, was there a question or?
Yeah, how is it working with
Grumpy? Oh, you know, I'm an animal lover. I grew up with cats and dogs, goldfish and lizards, and I had a couple of rabbits that were eaten by coyotes, actually. Probably could have left. Grumpy Cat, her real name is Tartar Sauce, and I think she's a little slow mentally. I don't know what the right term would be, but you know, the owner would move her and place her on a seat or like a bench or something, and then Tartar Sauce would just sit there and just take it all in. You weren't allowed to touch her unless the owner let you touch her, and it's because I was fortunate enough to act with Miss Tartar Sauce, they let me hold her, which was cool. I actually have a photo I should post out or tweet out. I don't know if I have before, but it was cool. Like, I mean, Grumpy Cat, like, that cat made, like, $100 million or something stupid like that, you know? And that movie was fun. It didn't take itself too seriously, which I really appreciated. When I read the script, I'm like, oh, they're poking fun at themselves the whole time. I had like 2 or 3 scenes with a cat, and then I had that one scene with that big dog. I don't know if you remember, where the dog tackled me and licked my face. That was pretty cool. That sounded weird. But it was cool.
Thanks.
You're welcome. And it was actually shot in my hometown, too. I grew up in Coquitlam, which is outside of Vancouver by about 20, 25 minutes, and they shot it at the mall there, which is just by my old high school. So it was kind of cool going back and representing. Hello.
Hi, welcome back to Vegas.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming. You alright?
I think I'm okay.
So I was just wondering, what is your favorite standout con moment?
Favorite standout con moment? To be honest with you guys, it's gonna sound super cheeseball, but I really do enjoy connecting with everyone here and coming and laughing and then, you know, asking people to tweet at me and I tweet back. I really enjoy the fan interaction. And other than that, like, I've met some really cool guys. Like, Adam Rose and I are, like, I consider us friends. And Ozra Chow, like, we're buddies. And Chad, I can't wait to see Chad. And of course, the whole band. Like, I'm always happy to see everyone. Now, a moment, I remember watching Travis, it was my first convention, I remember watching Travis give Chad a lap dance on stage. And that was my first convention. I didn't really know what I was in for, and that certainly set the tone. So I knew after that, pretty much anything went. And we'll see if maybe we can surpass that this weekend. You're welcome, thanks for the question.
Hi.
Hi.
So Samantha's death is really, really sad. If they were to find a way to bring Samantha back to life, would you be willing to play him again?
Hell yeah. But it had to be Samantha in Alfie's body, I suppose, right? Because he could end up anywhere. But to answer your question, hell yeah, I would. Maybe we could get a different outfit. Actually, no, fuck it. I swear. Actually, screw it. The hot dog outfit is now part of me. Maybe one convention and I'll show up in it, I don't know. I'd have to get whoever makes Osric's costume, because I'd have to get in touch with Osric, because Osric always looks so amazing. But hell yeah, I'd come back. I told the boys, well, just throw me in the trunk, and whenever you need me, open the trunk, I'll pop out, be your third wheel.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
I personally liked the episode Bugs.
That's what I'm talking about.
I just wanted to know what it was like for you to film it. Did you actually touch bugs?
Yeah, actually, they made us do this a test before to make sure we weren't allergic to bees, because in that one of the finale scenes, we're in an attic with like 50,000 bees or something ridiculous. So when we began production for the episode, they actually had a bee wrangler, and he put a little filter on your skin, and then he would have the bee sting you through the filter, and the filter was there so the bee didn't die every time it stung someone, otherwise that would be like really ruthless. So we all got stung beforehand. None of us were allergic, thankfully. And I remember when we were filming that, climax scene when we're all in the attic and the bees are coming and all the bugs are coming. They built like an attic area, and they released like tens of thousands of bees, but the bees just kept swarming towards the legs. So that's why they had to add all that CGI later. And I remember being in there with Jensen and Jared and the actors who were playing my parents, and Kim Manners was directing the episode. And he actually took a lot of the crew members who were in there were wearing like bee protective outfits, and then all of us actors were just like wearing clothes. And so Kim actually took his bee protective outfit off and came into the attic with us just to show solidarity. And that was a moment that I will remember probably forever. you know, just it just showed the character of that man, you know, willing to get in there with the rest of us and, yeah, you know, a small gesture like that goes a really long way, especially for someone like me who was just starting in the industry. Yeah, I've nothing but great things to say about Kim and the whole crew and, you know, that episode. Like, I know people poke fun at it, and I poke fun at it too, but it was an amazing experience, and I wouldn't, you know, change it for anything.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hello.
Hi. I have a little two-part question.
Two-part?
Yes.
Part A and part B.
Yes. With some Andrea. My daughter introduced me and my husband, who's now passed, into the show in the late of July of 2018. So we ended up binge-watching over the August 1st weekend of Supernatural. So my husband had a background before. He was in the military and in the military, religious studies and everything. So here's my question. Were you religious before the show started, and has the show changed any of your views on religion?
I didn't grow up in a religious household. My little sister went to church with my grandmother, and she was, you know, she took the Christianity route. But I didn't grow up in a religious household. I respect and appreciate all religions and beliefs. You know, do I believe there's a power out there? Absolutely. You know, like I said, the community aspect. So I did have another religious sort of experience, but it wasn't supernatural related.
Oh, okay.
All right,
the second question.
Oh, yeah, B.
With Blaine Simandrio, you got to play with Crowley and Castiel.
You got to play with me.
And, yeah. And of course, you know, Sam and Danny. Who was the one that you enjoyed interacting and acting on the show the most?
Jared and Jensen are, you know, great guys, and I interacted with them a little bit more in season one. I gotta say, Crowley, Mark Shepard, was probably my favorite interaction, just because it was so bizarre, you know? Like, I'm strapped in a chair, I got a helmet crown on my head poking into my temples, and I remember he was poking fun at me. While I was seated there, you know, and he was such a nice guy for someone who seems like the biggest a-hole on the camera. He's a really, really nice guy, and actually, he was the one who suggested the convention circuit, too. I remember he brought it up. He's like, you know, you've been doing a number of episodes now, and your character is an angel. He says, you know, maybe you'll find yourself here, and here I am, like, I don't know, 3-4 years later now, so I would have to say Mark Shepard. Pleasure's mine.
Hey.
Hey.
I was wondering, you hear a lot of stuff about how the cast plays pranks on people. I was wondering if they pulled any pranks on you.
No. The day when I was with all the cast was the day where I was strapped in a chair, bloody and screaming. So I think they may have taken a little bit of pity on me. I'm thinking. But I remember Jared, they had a fight sequence that same day because, you know, they come and rescue me, right? They come and save me, spoiler alert, and then Castiel kills me. Still affects you, I love it. but there was a time where Jared was rehearsing the fight scene with Jensen and the boys, and then Jared faked an injury. He faked that he had hurt his shoulder, so he was screaming in pain. And of course, that scared the crap out of the entire crew. And then Jared pops up smiling and laughing, you know, just to get everyone going. So it wasn't to me directly, but I did witness them messing around. And that's what makes that set so beautiful. Everything's lighthearted, they're laughing, they're joking. You know, you go to some sets, there's no laughter, there's no fun. It's very much a business sometimes, and they want the best product. And unfortunately, sometimes happiness kind of, you know, falls to the side. But that's never an issue on the Supernatural set. I had a buddy of mine who just did another episode, actually, and he had nothing but great things to say again. Like, and you know, you wonder why they go 12 episodes. They keep it light.
seasons. Thanks, man.
Seasons. In one episode a season. Hey!
My question would be, how do you feel your character Stuart from Letterkenny would react to being in the supernatural universe?
Oh my goodness. I don't know if anyone has seen the show Letterkenny. It's that's a couple claps, loving that. It's a show we do in Canada where it's a small town Canada, so there is you can scream for Canada all day long. It's about small towns, so there's a group of hicks, group of hockey players, and a group of skids, and I'm the lead of the skid. So I have long black hair, I have a choker, my nails are black, I have like black eyeliner. People always make fun of me saying I look like My Chemical Romance. And my character is like, you know, we dance all the time, and we sell cigarettes outside of like the convenience store for like a dollar each to kids and stuff. Like, it's a very wild, wild show. So if you get a chance to check it out, it's called Letterkenny. I'm going back in a few weeks to we're shooting 18 more episodes, so there's a lot more Letterkenny to come. It's really cool, but. As far as Stuart reacting in the supernatural world, I think he would have a panic attack and probably run into traffic, and that might be the end of Stuart, you know? Because he doesn't deal well with new environments, and this environment would probably be overwhelming for him. Yeah. Maybe he'd get out of his black attire a little bit longer. We were super goth season one. Like, the network had to be like, okay, maybe take it down a little bit. Cause it was like, you know, we had like, you know, scratch marks on our neck and, you know, nail polish, and we looked like rats, you know? And then season two, they had us do a little bit of a makeover. So I still have the long hair, but I'm more of like a fashionista. So I haven't even read season three yet. I have the episodes in my email. So I'm looking forward to see what happens in season three.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for the question. I appreciate the Letterkenny shout out too. Letterkenny, check it out. Hi.
Hi. So Spandril's death was not okay. I had to leave her room for a couple minutes because I was so angry.
Good.
So if he would have come back, do you think he'd hold a grudge against Cass for killing him?
No, I don't think he would. I think he understands that it wasn't Castiel who did it. You know, I think he knows that the orders came from a little higher up. And I think he'd forgive him, for sure. Because that's what friends do, you know? And I think they were great friends, they were brothers. And we make mistakes. They don't always entail killing each other. It's a little harder to forgive. But I'd say he forgave.
Thank you.
You're welcome, thanks for the question.
Hi, Tyler.
Hi.
Thank you so much for coming on late notice.
Guys, I'm so happy to be here. Okay. Yeah. I'm in Vegas, I'm with you guys. I'm out of the snow.
So my question for you is, what was your reaction when you saw the script that your character died?
I think it was a bunch of curse words. It's funny because like when you're reading the script, and not the whole episode, but like, you know, the episode was about saving some Andrea. We had to get in there, we had to get him out, you know? So I'm reading, I'm like, okay, yeah. They're gonna come get me, they're gonna save me, I'm gonna do 55 more episodes, and it's just gonna be how it is. And then when you get to the scene where Castiel, your buddy, ends up stabbing you against a car, it sucked. You never wanna die on a TV show, you know? I mean, this show's a bit of an exception, I think, but I was bummed out. Because like I just mentioned, when they sized me for another pair of pants, I was thinking maybe I was gonna stick around for a little while. But they did that probably just so they could spill blood on one pair of pants and then change me into the other one. So I was bummed out.
But we hope you come back.
Thank you. I wonder if that's in the cards. How many years has that been now? Four? Three?
Mary came back.
It happens, right? People come back. And everyone says they didn't see the wings when I got stabbed. So maybe like season 16 will come back or something. And now I own a hot dog stand. I'm an owner.
He's moving up in the world.
The Wiener Hut. The Wiener Hut's mine. Hi.
Hi. So what would a first date with Alfie be like? And what would a first date with you be like?
Ooh.
What with me? Be a nice, chill bottle of wine. Some music playing. You'd be making me dinner.
Oh!
2017!
That's so what? We can both make meals.
You make me dinner.
Okay, what do you want?
Steak.
Okay. Okay. Broccoli? Asparagus? You tell me, what's on the menu?
Asparagus.
I love asparagus.
Chocolate afterwards?
Okay, now we're talking dessert already. I feed it to you. But I thought it's 2017.
Oh!
Why don't you try it, you? Huh. It's funny. Oh, wow. It's funny, the 2017 argument just worked both ways for her.
We're gonna put you in like a little thong thing.
Thong in the 1800s?
The fanning with the grapes.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. And that would be, I would be doing that to you. Feeding you grapes, fanning you, feeding you chocolate, making you steak potatoes.
You
and
are healthy, I mean.
Oh, well, who do you want? You tell me. Am I wearing, it didn't sound, it sounds like you're fancy. No, well, let me think. My girlfriend right now, we went out for dinner. We went and got sushi, which is a big Vancouver thing to do. And then we went for a walk around Granville Island. And then we went to an improv show at Vancouver Theatre Sports, which is, you know, a great theater in Vancouver where guys and girls get on stage and make you laugh with improv. We went and saw two shows there. And that was my first date with her. As for Samandriel, I imagine he probably doesn't have too much cash flow. Oh, Alfie, right? We're talking about Alfie. He probably doesn't have too much cash flow, so he probably had hot dogs for dinner. And maybe a cup of water. And I'd put you on my bicycle on the handlebars. And then we'd probably ride somewhere and get some ice cream and finish things off. That's where the big bucks would go. And then I'd ride you home safely and give you a nice tight hug. That's it. Oh man, I want to make so many jokes right now. I don't know who's in the audience, what the age range is here, what I can say. Well, it has to do with, like, you know, wieners. Does that suffice? I really can't see anything. God? Next question.
One, I love you and I love Samandriel.
Thank you.
And then my question is, which one's more uncomfortable? The like weird halo thing and like being covered in blood or the mutant hunt suit thing?
Can you say that again?
Which was more comfortable to wear? Like halo and being covered in blood, like that costume, or the
wiener outfit?
Yeah.
Definitely the head piece. Yeah, it was, like I mentioned, I'm actually strapped into a chair, so my arms are strapped to the arms. And then they put this metal piece on my head that was not light, it was very heavy, and they had pressure points that went into my temples. So now I have this big metal piece sitting on my head, pushing into my temples, while I'm screaming for an extended period of time. And I was trying hard, you know, really hard not to complain. And everyone on set was really great. Like when I had a little bit of a break, they would unstrap me, but there was periods of time where like they just left me in the chair. I couldn't adjust the headset at all. Like, it was not comfortable. But I think the scene turned out really well, so I'm happy with how it turned out. I didn't lose an eye or anything. I didn't pass out or anything like that. But definitely that headpiece. I would wear that costume 10 times out of 10 before that headpiece. But I'd do it again. Don't get me wrong. I'd do it again.
Thank you.
Thank you. I had a serious headache after that, actually.
If your character came back to life, who would you most want to have a scene with?
Chuck. Woo! Yeah, he could probably do wonders for my character. Yeah, maybe I'll get Chuck's good books. I like that suggestion. I'm gonna go with Chuck. I've done Jared, I've done Jensen.
Yeah,
let God bring me back to life. I think that's the call. Yeah.
Thank you.
Or Naomi, get her back.
Yeah, Calvin.
Thank you.
Okay, first, you're not the only one in snippets. I came from Reno, where it was snowy as hell, so.
Really? Okay. I feel better about my choice.
I know you probably had this question a few times, but what is your take on the fandom, like, knowing you as the baby angel?
Aww. Aww.
I've never heard it put like that. I'm processing. I mean, how can I complain about that? That's a very endearing way of putting it, you know? I've been called a lot worse in the past, and I love it. I mean, I get to be, you know, a youthful angel who stuck around for a few episodes and then, you know, died a brutal death and ripped out the hearts of a bunch of fans. So I'm okay with people calling me the baby angel.
You're like the baby angel. You're like the innocent one.
Yes, he didn't deserve to die. He was, Samandriel was good. Yeah, I'm cool with it. I mean, there's a lot worse things to be called. And, you know, I kind of understand now when I look back at some of those photos. I mean, I was quite young then. I was like in my earlier 20s and I was wearing this wiener hot dog outfit. It was very, I don't know what the word would be. It was very youthful.
Pre-pubescent?
God?
Wow, the sound guy thinks you're pre-pubescent. Weird.
I guess my time's up, huh?
What gave you that clue? What's the subtle hint?
I'm pretty observant.